First thing, I wanted to go over the daily schedule. According to the schedule, the boys get up between 3:30 and 3:45 tonight.
Why so early?
Why 3:30 and 3:45? That's what time we all get up.
We are holding Mangala at 5.
Right.
So why 3:30?
Well, they do japa.
I tell you too early. The first hour.
They're accustomed to getting. They've been getting up at that time for years.
They're accustomed, that is all right. But otherwise, it is not needed so early. When they go to sleep?
At 8:15.
Oh, then it is all right. Then it is all right. At least they must have rest 6 hours.
They're ready, bathed, dressed by about 4:10. So they chant japa from 4:10 until 5 o'clock under the supervision of their teacher. Then arti, tulsi worship. And after tulsi worship, they again have japa up until Guru Puja, greeting the deities. From the time tulsi worship is over until the time of greeting the deities.
How long, Di?
That's 1 hour and 15 minutes. Altogether, they have japa time amounting to just over 2 hours.
While they can devote so much time.
Well, these are not small boys.
Oh.
These are
teachers.
At least 10 years, 9, 10 years old.
Mister.
14 years
old. They should be engaged in chanting and not sit down and japa. That will not be possible for them.
The problem is that some of the boys are 14, 15, and 13. But they should chant japa because they're required to chant 16 rounds a day. Many of them are
16 rounds requires at most 2 hours, 2.5 hours.
Well, 2 hours is on the schedule. 2 hours and 10 minutes. So they have 2 hours and 5 minutes of japa.
In some ways, they're younger, they make a vow to do less, and then they can study.
Some of the younger boys chant 6 or 8 rounds instead of 16. They chant that much during that time, and they study at the same time. Then they attend the temple programs, Guru Puja and Bhagavatam class. And then after that they go upstairs, wash their clothes and clean the ashram. That takes them about an hour. Wash their clothes and sweep and cleanse the floor, cleanse the shower room, wash their clothes.
Now, when they chant the mantras,
Brahma Samhita?
Or any?
Any mantra. Right now they're chanting from 9 until 9:30 in the morning with Yashodhananda Maharaj.
Early in the morning?
In the early morning, I pick some of the boys in the deity room. Between 5:30 and 6, the boys are the deities. The boys we are chanting up from
deity is temple.
Yes.
Deity, what do you mean the deity room?
Within the deity room, when they are waiting the deities, we are offering the prayers to the deities. The Brahma Samhita and the Shukla.
Why? Why? Deity room, within the deity room there is no need of chanting. Who told you this? There is no need. Within the deity room? You told me?
No.
Then?
Sometimes you said for installation, or other times when the deity is being made, you chant promised any prayers.
Within the deity room there is no business. No business.
When we hear the chanting, that's where it's coming from in the morning.
They can chant outside. Yeah. The deity bathing or whatever dressing may go on, you can chant, not within the deity.
How long do you
chant? That you can do outside. Then when that reading, writing begins?
That begins at 10:15 after prasadam. They take prasadam at 9:30. And then at 10:15, their English class begins.
Just after taking prasadam?
Yes, 15 minutes after.
What begins?
English class. That goes for 1.5 hours. Then there's math class, which goes for 45 minutes.
Not continually. They should be given a recess, 10 minutes. Then again come to the class. And the class should not be more than 45 minutes. One class should not be continued more than 45 minutes. Then 10 minutes recess, then begin another class.
For the English program, it is required in order for them to have enough time to read and write, they would require 1.5 hours, so we would have 2 classes.
In the meantime, 1.5.
Yes.
You give 10 minutes recess.
And during the recess, what should they do?
Nothing. They'll be free. Nothing to do. Recess means nothing to do. That is brain, I want to say, rest. Or continually you cannot do that. That's not good. At most 40 minutes or 45 minutes, then give them 10 minutes freedom, and then begin another. Not more than 40 to 45 minutes at a time. What about reading, writing?
After class then, by 12:30, they bathe again. Second time.
They take prasadam first and then bathe.
They take prasadam at 9 o'clock in the morning, 9:30. Then they have class. After class is finished, then they bathe.
After class they bathe?
Around 12:30. After
not midday. After prasadam they should not take bathing at least for 4 hours.
4 hours.
They have a schedule where they have dal, rice, and sabji, and chapati at 9:30 in the morning. They have in the afternoon.
So, when they first take bathing?
When they rise, at around 4 o'clock.
Oh, that's right. Then they take the prasadam at what time?
9:30.
So,
we can take prasadam earlier.
No, why early? Earlier, any breakfast?
No.
So why not? They are children, they must have some breakfast.
They have 3 meals. This is the way the temple program is scheduled. The temple eats at 9:30 in the morning. So therefore the boys also get prasadam at that time. Everybody eats the same
prasadam. But early in the morning they should have some, at least once sweet meat, something like that.
Lectura.
Lectura
and curds. They can take. After taking bath at 1 o'clock, they can take prasadam.
Early in the morning, just after Mangalarti, they can take something. They must take something. They are taking bathing at what time?
In the morning.
Huh?
10 to 4.
Huh?
4 o'clock, around 4 o'clock.
4 o'clock. So after Mangalarti, the Mangalarti prasadam should be given there. A little sweet.
We have
Mangalarti sweets, they should be distributed among the children. Little sweets. Then they can take 9:30 prasadam.
Full prasadam.
Yeah. Then, again, they're taking bathing at what time?
The scheduled next bathing is 12:30.
Then what is the 12:30 then?
After bathing, they take a little prasadam.
Yeah, that's nice. Then it'll be all right.
Then at 1:30, they take some rest.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's nice. How long?
1 hour.
That's nice.
Then they have Sanskrit class from 2:30 until 4.
Mm. 2:30, 4, that's all.
1.5 hours. So that should be a recess in between.
Mm?
That's 1.5 hours, so there should be recess.
10 minutes at least.
Then, at 4 o'clock, the chanting party leaves for the Jumun procession.
In process, that's right.
And they return by 6 for Darshan in the temple room.
Let them return by 5:30.
5:30. But, because darshan begins at 5:30, they should be there by 5:30.
No, darshan begins at 5. 5:30. 5:30? Yes. Why?
It was at 6 o'clock.
Huh?
In the evening.
Originally it was at 6 o'clock.
No, no. Darshan opens at 5.
No, when you come into the temple, your darshan.
No, my darshan is different, public darshan. Why the deity room is open?
At 5 o'clock.
Let's see. So why do you say 6?
I meant that when the darshan period for yourself was at 6.
Now it should be
5:30. 5:30.
General darshan is open at 5.
Oh,
yes. That's nice.
So then the boys will return at 5:30.
I think it may be a little earlier. No, half an hour.
Half an hour it will be, because the RC is going at 6:30, so
yeah.
The darshan will be at 4:30.
Yes.
That we had managed last year.
Yes.
Then the boys would come and for the chanting and recitation of Srimad Bhagavatam.
What time?
5:30 to 6:30.
5:30 we begin class. In that class they can chant.
Kirtan.
Yes.
Yes.
That's right.
And then at 6:30 there'll be arti, they'll stay for arti. Then after arti they take a little prasadam and then take rest.
That's right. That's all right. Give them sumptuous food so that they become healthy, nice food. Yes. That is also wanted, children, they must eat sufficiently. Not ovary. Even ovary, that is not wrong for children. And that will be exercise by going to Jamuna and coming.
Yeah.
That will be bodily exercise. These things, do that, strictly follow. There is no scarcity of space. Yeah, yes. Vrindavan is holy place. And there is no government interference. So increase it. Bring more students from all over the world, then it will be unique. And you also make scheme to get Indian children from aristocratic family. Suchinang Simatange Yoga Bhrasta Sanjay. Those are born in high class, rich family, Brahmin family. They are not ordinary. But there is no Brahmin family now. At least the richer section, they can be induced to send their boy to learn Sanskrit and English and Bhagavad Bhakti. They can do business or whatever like they can do later on. But these things, they should be, father and mother should be careful. Just attract all good family children. Working, they will have to leave. They cannot. They cannot become pandit or spiritually advanced children. They have to work. But if the richer section, they get their sons good character, good devotee. Chanakya Pandit says, Kortaputrena jatena juna vidyan na bhaktivan. What is the use of such son who is neither devotee nor learned? Kanena chakkusa akin chakshu piraiva kevan. What is the use of blind eyes? It is simply troublesome. So if these aristocratic families, they do not give education in spiritual line, they will become all hippies, loafer, and drinking, and wasting father's money. They should be informed. Classes to be arranged according to the number of students increases. That's all right.
And now there are two classes.
No.
There are two classes according to age.
Although according to time and circumstance.
In my opinion, Prabhupada, there should be one period for Hindi classes.
That's very nice.
40 minutes, 45 minutes.
Yes.
For the children.
Very good. That is essential. If the Indian students come, they will require some Bhandikunda language.
Hindi class, yes. In Vrindavan, they will.
Oh, yes. Do that. Hindi.
In Mayapur, should be Bengala class, and Hindi and Bengala, two languages are very common.
Yes. Not any other language. Hindi is essential. Must be compulsory. Hindi. That is state language.
For the Western children also?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Everyone.
You should find some time, adjust some time for Hindi.
Hindi, Sanskrit, English, compulsory.
That's all.
And the government also like that. That foreign student.
They can understand language.
Oh yes, Hindi is essential. It is not difficult, the same principle as Sanskrit. Reading and writing, that's all. This Gurukul is for high class, Brahmin Kshatriyas, not for the Vaishyas and Shudras. Now everyone is required for Krishna's service. But that I was describing today, there must be division. Don't put horse before a cart.
Race horse before the cart.
Yeah, that will not be nice. Now, if one cannot take education, he can use in farm work, little hard work. Hyderabad should be for grihasthas, for ploughing, for growing and flowers, like that. No education required.
He is not interested in education.
No, education. No. That is waste of. For such boys who are not interested, why they should be enforced? Education. They are not meant for that. Education is for higher brain, sober brain. And not that everyone has to become little. It is not required. He can do other work. Mm-hmm. Yes?
Prabhupada means that according to the nature you engage them.
Yeah. Guna karma vibhaga, sir. Guna karma vibhaga. You can do this, all I do it. Why you should be forced to learn Sanskrit? No necessary. not necessary.
You said to me, the tractor, you said, this is the cause of all the trouble, that it took all the work from the young men, and they went to the city and became entangled in the sense gratification in the cities.
Mm-hmm.
So I noticed in the city, there's much more passion, but living in the country,
yes, passion, but I must be, when you've got the facility, naturally, we are lusty, and we have got the facility, then we take to it.
The country is more peaceful, it's very easier to think of spiritual life.
Yeah. Less disease, less brain taxing, everything is less. So balanced time, utilize for Krishna God. And if you have a temple, very happy life. Just part your whole work little and balanced time, engage yourself in Krishna consciousness. This is ideal life. If you study only one flower, you become one consciousness. There is a machine which you call nature. From that machine, everything is coming. But how machine is perfect? And who has discovered this machine?
In London you said, they do not know that the butterflies and flowers are painted, but Krishna paints them with thought.
Yes. How can you expect without painting it has come so beautiful? This is foolish, nature. What is nature? Everything is being done by the machine of Krishna. Parasa Shakti Vividai Vasriyate. Anyway, improve this mode of life. Live in open place, produce your food land, produce your meal, save time, chantering. Plain living, high faith, ideal life. Artificial necessities of life. Do increase your so-called comfort. And if you forget your real business, that is suicide. We want to stop this suicidal policy. We don't want to stop the modern advancement of technology. Although the so-called advancement technology is suicidal, but we don't talk of this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has given a simple formula, chant Hare Krishna. Even in your technological factory, you can chant. What is wrong there? You go on putting on with your machine and chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna.
I don't think we have to worry about your disciples being in the criminal courts now, do we? Don't have to worry about that.
A magistrate or a lawyer is already graduate. If there is a lawyer, it is to be understood
that he has passed his graduate examination. Similarly, if one is Vaishnava, it is to be understood that he has already become a Brahmin. Is it clear? Why we offer you the sacred thread? That means that there is Brahminical standard. Unless one is Brahmin, he cannot become Vaishnava. Just like unless one is graduate, he cannot become a lawyer. So, as a lawyer means he is already graduate of India. Similarly, Vaishnava means he is already Brahmin.
So therefore, the Vaishnavas, they are all, they should have no contamination of passion and ignorance, therefore. They should all be on the platform
of Vaishnava means, bhakti means, bhakti parishanu bhava virakti annatasad. Bhakti means realization of God consciousness. And the symptom of God consciousness is that he is averse to all material activity. He has no interest.
So then the Brahmin has no interest in being, the Vaishnava has no interest in being Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, but he takes some specific occupation.
That is, he actually on the topmost position, he has no interest. But so long he is not so perfect, he has interest. Therefore, that interest should be corroborated, what is called, adjusted according to the Brahminical Kshatriya. Because in that time, the people are so rotten that they could not understand what is God. Therefore, he took out that. First of all, let them become sinless. Then one day will come, they will understand what is God. Lord Krass also said, thou shalt not kill. And the people at that time are killers. Otherwise, why does he say, thou shalt not kill? Why this fire?